Is that Tarzan over there?
Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, my name is Stefan, and today I'm going to share with you how you can practice earthing like Tarzan by thinking and being outside the box, and by how going outside and connecting your electromagnetic potential to that of the earth fundamentally improves your health and wellness, in four unconventional ways that you can practice earthing that are very powerful. We're shooting this live. I suggest you watch the entire video because you're gonna learn things here you won't learn anywhere else. So we're gonna start with the simple, which is that you should be barefoot when you're earthing, of course, and you just wanna go out to a lawn, a nice place, and do some movement during midday. This is when the sun is at its highest. This is when you have the strongest telluric currents in the ground, and this will improve your overall energy, mood, metabolism. And a simple way to do this is just if you have a nice backyard area, you can just give it a good rake. A lawn always likes a gentle rake of cleaning up some of the stuff around it. This could also just be playing on the lawn, having fun, practicing handstands, cartwheels. I mean, just walking, just doing something that moves the body, gets it active, gets the heart rate up a little bit. While you're barefoot on the ground is going to be really, really good for you. And that is all natural currents that we're exposing yourself to. There's no power grid source when you're doing this. Now you'll notice here this tree, this is the second way that you can practice earthing. And this is just like an aura cleansing. So trees have this very wide biofield, because they have very deep and wide roots, and they also are very tall and have wide limbs. So they have this very big biofield, which you can immerse yourself in. You can just stand here and just let your biofield be cleansed. The wind blows, it just releases some of these more ephemeral and lighter energies that you don't want. You can also hug a tree. That's a great way to do it. So you just, hey buddy, am I in the frame here? Sorry, let me. I said we're doing this live. Okay, we're off the tripod. So you can just hug a tree like this and just say hello. And this is a very good stabilizing and balancing energy. And what's special about this tree is that it actually, see if you can see that. Where is it? We have right here a little bit of metal stuck in the tree. Someone, you know, was a little careless with this tree in the past, and it just absorbed around this metal. But what that means when we're thinking out of the box is that you now have a conductive metallic pathway into the vascular system of the tree, which then connects to the roots of the tree, which then means you're now more connected to telluric currents that are flowing tens of meters underground. And those are the very low frequency, high power currents. So you could do this and ground to the tree by holding or touching onto some extremely conductive pathway. And this is very quickly stabilizing and balancing, and really just gets you aligned and just nice and straight. Just make sure right now you're also exposing the tree and its internals to your energy. So make sure that you are, you know, thinking good thoughts, that you're just in a good place of mind. For example, you could think, like, we are healing, I am healing. That's always a good one. Very simple stuff, like I am stable, I am balanced, I am strong. While you're doing this earthing, deep breathing throughout, this is really good for just getting quickly grounded if you're feeling very unsettled, or if you just really feel like you need to course correct a bit, then you can do that. Now, some of you are certainly new to this. You're wondering, what is earthing? Earthing is very simple. The human body is bioelectric. That means that it has electromagnetic potentials at various levels of scale, going from the atomic all the way up to the cellular and then the human, the overall biofield. And earthing is all about normalizing this, balancing this, bringing this to its optimal potential as you continue on for your best health and wellness, for your best genetics, for your best life and happiness and all these things. And the way to do that primarily is to get in contact with the earth, because she has her own electromagnetic currents and potentials, and all those are circadian signals for us that help us with our hormone production, that help us with knowing when to go to sleep and when to wake up and normal things like that, important things like that. So we are going to talk about a more complex way of earthing with the tent there, but before that, I want to start with something more simple, something that you should be doing more often, which is you can practice earthing and grounding yourself and just feeling better and more stable and balanced with things that grew in the earth. So this is dandelion root right here. Really amazing herb, super safe. You can have a lot of it. It's no problem. Then of course you have your garlic and you have your onion and potato. We all love potatoes and parsnips back there. These guys are all really, really great for your bioelectric system and for grounding yourself, because you can include them in your diet even when you can't go outside. So if it's like too cold out here, you're just not comfortable with it, you're not feeling it, you don't have access to this, then root vegetables and herbs, roots and rhizomes are really good ways to ground yourself, and you can have them at any time. Now, here we have the special tent. This is gonna be a fun exploration for you all. This is a earthing tent. So effectively what I'm doing here is creating a larger field of potential. And the larger the field of potential, the conductive field of potential you have, the more deep effects you can get with earthing. So we have a copper rod right here going down about 2 feet, so about a half a meter or so. And you see that this has a wire going to it, and I have it set up to a copper sheet on the inside. So we have the copper rod for the head, and then we have steel stakes going the same depth, going all the way about a foot and a half for the feet. And you see the copper there. We're gonna come back to this because this is actually a special line that runs out. But first I'll show you inside the tent, and you can set up something like this. So you can come out here anytime. If you have a backyard space, you actually go to the park and do this. It takes a while though, set up. But this is a copper sheath right here. So this is highly conductive copper that I have wired to, just tied to a steel ring, which then goes to those wires. And I just lay some natural blankets on top. So you create this field of potential just by being out here. Just by having the tent on the ground, you're much closer to the Earth's neutral field of potential. And then by bringing the copper sheet inside the tent and doing this, then you can really bring these currents from, below the surface up like this and then through into the sheet. So we have that going to the back of the tent as well. And then here's where it gets really fun, is that I'm increasing the field of potential with this by A, just running the steel wire outside. That itself is creating a conductive pathway. And then there's also a ground rod over here. So this is a really old ground rod out by the creek. And that thing is sunken deep. I mean, that's also very saturated clay, so highly conductive geology right here. Two big trees coming up. So I'm tapping into that ground rod with this line that I have going like this, and that travels all the way to the tent. And this tent, as you can see, is within a very large, nice open area. So this is creating a very strong connection to very large fields of potential. Those fields of potential are going down to the water table in this instance, because we have the creek pretty shallow here. And the further down you go into these tellurics, the deeper the bioelectric regenerating effects are. The greater the reset and stabilizing effects, the normalization effects, and the DNA activations that you get. A lot of people want to are interested in earthing because they have, let's say, chronic disease, or they're in a lot of pain, or they have a lot of inflammation, and this is what you would do if you really need to do some deep healing. Then you would set up a tent like this, and you can go out there during midday if it's, depending on the temperature and your comfort level. You can come out here during midday, the tent will be nice and warm. You could do a 90-minute sleep cycle. So do a deep Bioelectric reset in 90 minutes. Put on some yoga nidra if you want to really make it easy. You could also sleep out here. I've been sleeping out here. The Germans did this back in the late 1800s. They did a lot of earthing outside. There was a whole group surrounding it, and you hope that comes back, because I've noticed that by sleeping out here, it's really been a game changer in many ways. For example, I do a lot of strength training. The amount of exercise and fitness I can do goes way up when I'm earthing, because muscle protein synthesis goes up and muscle protein breakdown goes down by improving your nitrogen metabolism. So you can do things like that. And then if you're really interested, here's the last thing. If you're really interested in like the spirituality aspects, then this is a great way to have some incredibly vivid dreams. When you connect yourself to the earth in the bioelectric system is really integrated with the telluric system of the planet, which has these huge energies, and so much wisdom and information is stored in these energetic layers like the Schumann resonances, then you improve and optimize your brainwave patterns and the coherency of your brainwaves, and you can have some really, really crazy dreams. Vivid dreams, lucid dreams, precognition dreams. I've had all those. And they definitely get potentiated while you're earthing, specifically when you're earthing at night. So earthing during the day is great, going outside, getting your feet on the ground. But what is, if you really want the deep benefits of earthing, you have to figure out how you can earth yourself at night. And I don't recommend using an earth sheet plugged into a house and a power grid, because that's all 50 or 60 hertz energy, and you're just like this. So these are some out-of-the-box ways you can practice earthing. They're really not out-of-the-box. They're actually very in line with what we should be doing and what our ancestors did, but this is kind of more 21st or 22nd or 25th century way of looking at it, how you can build your field of potentials in the process of improving yours, cleansing yours, healing yours, growing yours, connecting yours, all the great things with energy. So I wish you all the best with your earthing. If you want to learn more about earthing, I have other videos on the topic. You can watch them here. You can learn about the Schumann resonances, a big component of earthing there. And I'll see you all in future videos. Thanks for watching, subscribe, and have a great day. Ciao.